It's time for English on the Go. So we're going to look at Rika's full clip where she actually tells us about a mistake that she made while driving her parents' car. Let's find out more.
Just wanna ignite ya!
Are you ready? Go!
Making mistakes is part of everyone's life, and I've definitely made my fair share of mistakes. But when I make mistakes that have consequences for other people, I can almost feel traumatized because I feel so guilty. One time when my parents were on holiday for a week, I was allowed to use the car because I stayed at home, and I scraped the side of the car when I went through a very narrow gate. My dad had warned me about this gate, but I had brushed it off and said, "Don't worry about it, I'll be fine." When I then had to tell them on video call, I felt so guilty that I started to cry in the middle of trying to explain it. And their reaction showed me that I was letting my conscience get the better of me. They weren't actually that upset because it's just an item. So I learned two things. I learned to drive carefully when I go through narrow gates, but also not to let my conscience get the better of me. And that items are items. And as long as I'm aware of what I did and I say sorry, everything will be okay.
네, 오늘의 핵심 어휘 보겠습니다. 첫 번째, 결과를 뜻하는데요. Consequence, consequence인데 결과 중에서도 원치 않는 결과를 가리킬 때 많이 씁니다. 그리고 엄청난 충격을 주다, 보통 이제 트라우마라고 하는 거를 영어로 trauma라고 발음해 주는데요. 그것을 이용해서 traumatize, traumatize라고 합니다. 그리고 긁다, scrape, scrape. 발음 연습해 볼까요?
Let's practice our pronunciation starting with consequence, consequence, consequence. Next we have traumatize, traumatize, traumatize. Scrape, scrape, scrape. Let's look at some more vocabulary words.
그리고 어떤 이야기를 들었을 때 경고 같은 걸 들었을 때 무시하는 거 brush off라고 합니다. Brush off. 그리고 양심, 양심의 가책 conscience. 발음 연습해 볼게요.
Brush off, brush off, brush off. And lastly, we have conscience, conscience, conscience. Perfect. Let's take a look at Rika's clip once again, but with English subtitles.
Making mistakes is part of everyone's life, and I've definitely made my fair share of mistakes. But when I make mistakes that have consequences for other people, I can almost feel traumatized because I feel so guilty. One time when my parents were on holiday for a week, I was allowed to use the car because I stayed at home, and I scraped the side of the car when I went through a very narrow gate. My dad had warned me about this gate, but I had brushed it off and said, "Don't worry about it, I'll be fine." When I then had to tell them on video call, I felt so guilty that I started to cry in the middle of trying to explain it. And their reaction showed me that I was letting my conscience get the better of me. They weren't actually that upset because it's just an item. So I learned two things. I learned to drive carefully when I go through narrow gates, but also not to let my conscience get the better of me. And that items are items. And as long as I'm aware of what I did and I say sorry, everything will be okay.
Okay, so that is definitely something I can relate to because if I make a mistake that hurts others, I tend to feel very guilty as well.
Right? 다른 사람들이 뭐 상처를 받거나 피해를 right? 보게 되면은 죄책감 느끼게 되는 게 자연스러운 것 같아요. 특히 yeah. 이제 부모님 차를 가지고 갔다가 이제 긁었으니까 right? 지금 정말 미안했을 텐데 자, 첫 번째 줄부터 차근차근 보면서 공부 시작해 보겠습니다.
Sounds great.
Making mistakes is part of everyone's life, and I've definitely made my fair share of mistakes. But when I make mistakes that have consequences for other people, I can almost feel traumatized because I feel so guilty.
Making mistakes is part of everyone's life, and I've definitely made my fair share of mistakes.
Making mistakes, 실수를 하는 것은 우리말로는 실수를 한다라고 하지만 do mistakes라고는 잘 안 하죠.
Yeah.
항상 make라고 해요.
It's usually you make mistakes.
실수를 만들어내는 것처럼.
Yes.
그래서 실수를 하는 거는 part of everyone's life, mm-hmm. 모든 사람들의 삶의 일부, 그러니까 삶의 일부이고요. 그리고 and I've definitely 저도 확실히 mm-hmm. made my fair share of mistakes. Mm-hmm. 저도 꽤 실수를 많이 했어요라는 뜻인데 mm-hmm. 왜 그렇게 되는지를 생각해 보면 share라는 것은 나눠서 먹는 거를 uh-huh. 예를 들었을 때 my share, your share 자신의 몫을 가리키잖아요.
Yeah, it's the amount that you have. So my fair share means I've made enough.
네, 그러니까 fair share는 너무 적지도 않을 거예요.
Yeah.
네, 적당히 가져온다는 건 그래서 나도 이만큼 실수했어요 이런 mm-hmm. 뜻이고요.
Mm-hmm. And she says, but when I make mistakes that have consequences for other people.
그런데 다른 사람들에게 피해를 주는 실수를 제가 했을 때는 이라고 번역했습니다. Mm-hmm. 왜 피해가 되냐면, 자, 결과를 가리키는 이 단어는
That is consequence. Consequence.
Consequence. Mm-hmm. 이제 consequence의 이제 sequence 이 부분은 이제 또는 뭐 sequel 이렇게 할 때도 보면 따라오는 걸 말하는데
yeah, The thing that comes next.
네, 어떤 것을, 어떤 행동을 했을 때 그 뒤에 따라오는 일들이 있을 수 있겠죠.
Yeah.
좋은 결과, 나쁜 결과 있을 수 있는데 mm-hmm. consequence는 일반적으로 안 좋은 결과예요.
Yeah. It's a bad 결과, right?
네, 사람들이 원치 않는 거.
Yeah, it's something you don't want.
그래서 예를 들어서 예문을 보면
mm-hmm. For example, you could say You must answer for the consequences.
어떤 일이 있었어요. Mm-hmm. 그래서 당신은 일의 결과에 책임을 져야 합니다.
Yes, you must be responsible for these consequences.
네.
Okay.
그렇기 때문에 좀 부정적인 결과라서 피해라고 번역이 가능한 거고요.
Yes.
다른 사람들에게 부정적인 결과가 있었을 때 그런 실수를 했을 때는 다음으로
mm-hmm. I can almost feel traumatized because I feel so guilty.
Because I feel so guilty.
Mm-hmm.
정말 죄책감이 들어서 너무 죄책감이 들어서 I can almost feel
traumatized. Traumatized.
네, traumatized. Mm-hmm. 엄청난 충격을 겪을 수 있어요. I can mm-hmm. feel traumatized. 트라우마를 겪을 수도 있어요.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
All right. Let's look at the next part.
One time when my parents were on holiday for a week, I was allowed to use the car because I stayed at home, and I scraped the side of the car when I went through a very narrow gate.
One time when my parents were on holiday for a week, I was allowed to use the car because I stayed at home.
한 번은 이런 일이 있었습니다라고 할 때 one time 자주 쓰는 표현이고요. Mm-hmm. One time when my parents were on holiday for a week. Mm-hmm. 한 번은 부모님이 일주일간 휴가를 가셨을 때 mm-hmm. I was allowed 허락을 받았습니다. Mm-hmm. to use the car. Mm-hmm. 여기서 말하는 the라는 거는 왜 그 자동차라고 했냐면 그냥 the car that their family
yeah,
had.
The family car.
그렇죠?
Right?
굳이 a car, my parents' car라고 하지 않고 그냥 the car 해도
the car.
문맥상 알 수 있습니다.
Of course it's the family's car, right?
Yeah, the car, right?
Yeah.
Because I stayed at home. 부모님은 휴가 가셨고 저는 집에 있었기 때문에 한 번은 그 차를 써도 된다고 허락을 받았었어요.
Mm-hmm. And she goes on to say, and I scraped the side of the car when I went through a very narrow gate.
When I went through a very narrow gate. Mm-hmm. 아주 좁은 문을 통과해 갔을 때 mm-hmm. 뭘 했냐면
I scraped the side of the car.
네.
To scrape.
긁다. 예문을 볼게요.
For example, I fell and scraped my knees.
I fell, 넘어져서 I scraped my knees. Mm-hmm. 무릎을 긁혔어요라는 뜻인데요. Scrape 같은 경우에는 물론 scratch도 긁다지만 scratch는 가려워서 긁을 때 scratch를 많이 쓸 수 있죠.
Uh-huh. And with scratch, we typically say our fingernails. You scratch with your fingernails. But if I'm using an object and I do the same thing, it's more like a scrape.
상처가 좀 남죠.
Right.
네, 그게 이제 scrape에 더 가깝고요.
Mm-hmm.
그리고 그런 경우에도 scrape 많이 쓰는 것 같습니다. 예를 들어서 여러분이 그 screwdriver, 드라이버로 mm-hmm. 뭔가 나사를 돌리려고 하는데 잘 안 돌아가거나 했을 때 그 mm-hmm. 십자 모양이 막 망가질 수 있잖아요.
Yeah.
You can say you're scraping the top or scraping the surface.
Yeah, you scraped the surface of it, right? It kind of scratched it and
네.
messed it up.
그렇죠.
Right?
그럴 때 scrape를 많이 쓰고요. Mm-hmm. 자동차 긁었을 때도 씁니다. 그래서 I scraped the side of the car. 차 옆을 긁었다고 했고요. 이 문장 같은 경우에는 사실 scraped the car 하면 충분히 scraped the side 하면 충분히 과거형이라는 걸 알 수 있는데 mm-hmm. 빠르게 말하면 scraped the인지 그냥 scrape the 현재형인지 과거형인지 문맥이 없으면 좀 헷갈릴 수 있어요.
Right? Because they do sound the same. Yeah. And I scrape the side, and I scrape the side.
특히 scrape, P 발음 뒤에 나오는 ED는 T로 발음이 되거든요.
Yes.
그래서
scraped the side.
Scraped the, scraped the.
Yeah,
비슷합니다.
Scraped the side,
yeah.
scraped the side.
Very, very similar.
Mm-hmm. Let's look at the next part.
My dad had warned me about this gate, but I had brushed it off and said, "Don't worry about it, I'll be fine." When I then had to tell them on video call, I felt so guilty that I started to cry in the middle of trying to explain it. And their reaction showed me that I was letting my conscience get the better of me.
My dad had warned me about this gate, but I had brushed it off and said, "Don't worry about it. I'll be fine."
그러니까 아빠가 여행을 떠나시기 전에 mm-hmm. 이런 이야기를 하시긴 하셨군요.
Yeah, he said, "Be careful about that gate."
Yeah. Don't scrape the side of the car.
Yes, 네. it's very narrow.
Had warned me니까 떠나시기 전에 mm-hmm. 경고를 하셨었습니다.
Yes.
해두신 상태였습니다. About this gate. Mm-hmm. 그분에 대해서 경고를 하셨었는데 But I had
brushed it off. Brushed it off, right? To brush off something.
네. 사실 brush 하면은 솔질 같은 거를 하는 거 brush이고
oh, yeah.
off니까 접촉이 안 되겠죠, 떨어지겠죠. Mm-hmm. 그래서 보통 이렇게 많이 제스처를 하죠.
Yeah, you go like this. And
off.
It could literally be brushing something if he had something on his shoulder. Let me brush it off
그렇죠.
for you.
그런데 이렇게 실제로 하는 거 말고도 어떤 사람이 말을 하면 이게 잔소리처럼 들렸을 때
Right, it's like
네, 뭔가 딱 나에게 와서 뭔가 부착되는 느낌이 있을 거 아니에요? 그러면 mm-hmm. brush it off 하면은 됐어. 이게 경고든 잔소리든 불평 불만이든 mm-hmm. 제대로 안 듣는 거예요. 무시하는
yeah.
거예요.
Anything that you don't really listen to or just kind of ignore.
Exactly.
Brushed it off.
It's similar to ignoring.
Mm-hmm.
그래서 그냥 무시하고는 어떻게 말하냐면 Don't worry about it. I'll be fine.
I'll be fine.
걱정 마세요. 괜찮을 거예요. 라고 한 다음이란 말이죠.
Mm-hmm. And then she said, When I then had to tell them on video call, I felt so guilty that I started to cry in the middle of trying to explain it.
When I had to tell them, 그들에게 말을 해야 했을 때 mm-hmm. on video call, 화상 전화로 on video call 이런 것도 재밌는 표현이고요.
Mm-hmm.
그리고 then이 들어간 거 재밌네요. When I then had to. 여기서 말하는 것은 한편으로는 됐어요 했는데 근데
right.
말해야 했죠.
Yeah, she already said it'll be okay.
네.
But then she had to tell them, oh, it wasn't
그렇죠.
okay.
이렇게 상황이 반전이 되었다라는 느낌을 mm-hmm. 이 then으로 살짝 살려주고요.
Mm-hmm.
I felt so guilty that I started to cry in the middle of trying to explain it. 어떤 일이 있었는지를 설명하려고 노력하는 in the middle of 와중에 갑자기 울기 시작했어요.
Mm.
왜냐하면 너무 죄책감이 들어서.
Right. And next she says, and their reaction showed me that I was letting my conscience get the better of me.
양심, 양심의 가책.
Conscience.
Mm-hmm. 이제 영어는 항상 발음이 불규칙한 게 너무 많아서 많은 사람들이
yeah.
불평을 하는데요. 보면 여러분, con 빼보면 우리가 알고 있는
science잖아요.
과학인데 con이 붙었다고 해서 갑자기
conscience.
발음이 바뀝니다. 불규칙적으로.
Yeah. Conscience. Makes no sense.
네, 그냥 적응할 수밖에 없어요.
yeah.
And their reaction showed me, 그들의 반응이 저에게 뭘 보여줬냐면 that I was letting my conscience get the better of me. Get the better of me라는 거는 사실은 Yeah.
When something gets the better of you, it kind of controls you or takes 그쵸. over. Takes 그쵸. over your thinking.
네, 너무 심하게 장악하는 거고 그렇게 해서는 안 되는데 여기서는 양심의 가책을 어느 정도는 느껴도 되는데
yeah.
너무 심하게 느끼고 있었다는 거예요.
Right. So if you let the anger get the better of you, it's the same thing. It's
네.
okay to be angry, but if it's too much, 화를, you're like,
그렇죠. 화를 지나치게 느끼고 있고
yes.
이렇게 뭔가 정도를 벗어났을 때
right.
you're letting an emotion get the better of you.
Yes. All right, let's look at the next part.
They weren't actually that upset because it's just an item. So I learned two things. I learned to drive carefully when I go through narrow gates, but also not to let my conscience get the better of me. And that items are items. And as long as I'm aware of what I did and I say sorry, everything will be okay.
They weren't actually that upset because it's just an item. So I learned two things.
부모님이 그렇게 사실은 화가 나지도 않았어요. Because it's just an item.
It's just an item.
그냥 물건일 뿐이니까요.
Yeah.
안 다친 게 중요하다 이런 이야기
of course.
같아요. So I learned two things. 그래서 저는 두 가지 교훈을 얻었어요.
And what are those two things? I learned to drive carefully when I go through narrow gates, but also not to let my conscience get the better of me.
네, 하나는 좁은 문을 통과해서 갈 때는 drive carefully, 조심히 운전하는 법도 배웠고 but also not to, 그러니까 learned not to. 네, 그래서 안 하는 방법도 배웠대요. Let my conscience get the better of me. 양심의 가책에 너무 시달리지 않는 방법도 배웠다고 합니다.
And lastly, she says, and that items are items. And as long as I'm aware of what I did and I say sorry, everything will be okay.
그리고 물건은 물건일 뿐, items are items. And as long as I am aware of what I did, 내가 한 행동을 내가 알고 있고, and I say sorry, 미안하다고 하는 한, everything will be okay. 모두 다 괜찮을 거라는 걸 배웠습니다. Of course, in life, not everything will be okay.
Yeah, sometimes you have to make amends, you have to pay for
exactly, it. Exactly, someone's car or something.
Right.
But still, yeah.
For sure. All right, well, that was a great lesson. Let's review her clip once again.
Making mistakes is part of everyone's life, and I've definitely made my fair share of mistakes. But when I make mistakes that have consequences for other people, I can almost feel traumatized because I feel so guilty. One time when my parents were on holiday for a week, I was allowed to use the car because I stayed at home, and I scraped the side of the car when I went through a very narrow gate. My dad had warned me about this gate, but I had brushed it off and said, "Don't worry about it, I'll be fine." When I then had to tell them on video call, I felt so guilty that I started to cry in the middle of trying to explain it, and their reaction showed me that I was letting my conscience get the better of me. They weren't actually that upset because it's just an item. So I learned two things. I learned to drive carefully when I go through narrow gates, but also not to let my conscience get the better of me. And that items are items. And as long as I'm aware of what I did and I say sorry, everything will be okay.